today we have taken the chapter 5th animals of class 7. In the previous video, we have uploaded different type of angle, corresponding angle, alternate interior angle, vertical opposite angle. Today we have taken the same portion out there. We have given the figure. Another figure that is given to you. This is given P. This is given Q. P and Q figure are given. A, B, C, D. And another transversal line. See the transversal line. Here A meets B. A, B, C, D. And one other angle is given to you. This is E, this is F, and 125. This figure is given to you. In the adjoining figure, find the unknown angle. If you know about the corresponding angle, alternate interior angle, vertical opposite angle, then you have to find this term A, B, C, D, E, F. You have to find it here. So here, firstly, you have to find that this line is parallel to this line. P parallel to Q. If P parallel to Q, so this side of the angle, this is 125 degree, that is given to you. This angle is equal to this. Why this angle is equal to this? Because this angle and this angle are corresponding angles. So D is equal to 125 degree. Right, equation is here. Corresponding angle. So using the property of corresponding angle, vertical opposite angle, and vertical interior angle, we have to find the angle. First, we have to find D angle, that is 125 degree. So this angle 125 degree, and this angle B. Angle B is also 125 degree. Why? This is equal, this is vertically opposite angle. In the short form, we can write it there VOA, vertically opposite angle. Angle B is equal to 125 degree. If 125 degree becomes out, then this angle B, so this angle E is equal to angle A. This is also a corresponding angle, but we don't know what is the angle of E. So here angle E or angle F, this is the vertical opposite angle. So either you can write here 125 plus F. 125 plus F, that is equal to 180 degree due to linear pair. So what is the linear pair? Linear pair is that in these two angle sum is equal to make a semicircle, is make a semicircle, set semicircle angle is 180 degree. So we have to find F. F is equal to 180 degree. 125 degree goes from the right hand side minus 125. So here F is equal to 180 minus 125 degree. That will be comes out 10 minus 5, 5, 7 minus 2, 5, 55 degree. So F is equal to 55 degree. So same here, F is equal to 55 degree. So same here, this is angle C. So angle angle C is equal to angle F, which is also corresponding angle. This is the corresponding angle. Angle C is equal to angle F, is corresponding angle. So here angle C is also 55 degrees. Angle C is also 55 degrees. So here we have to find it here angle A. Angle A equal to angle C, this is also vertically opposite angle. So this is vertical opposite angle. So angle A is also 55 degrees. Angle A is also 55 degrees. So same here, P parallel to Q, angle A is equal to angle E. So angle E is also 55 degrees, because this is equal to angle A. Same reason is here, that is corresponding angle. So we are using the property of corresponding angle. Here A we have to find, we have to find only B. So what is the angle of B? So same here, angle D is equal to angle B. Angle D is equal to angle B. Angle B. Angle D. So what is the angle of D? Don't find it then. So angle D, you have to find it then. It is 125 degrees. So angle B is also 125 degrees. Reason is vertically opposite angle. So which is the property of corresponding angle, vertical opposite angle, linear pair? We have to find the angle of A, B, C, D, E, and F. So any figure that is given to you, you have to find the angles. Next question is given, find the value of x in each of the following figure. If L parallel to M, in the first figure that is given to you, this is L, this is M, and one other transversal line is given to them. This is given as A. Angle is given, that is 110. 110 degrees. We have to find this x. We have to find x. So here 110 degrees, this is x. So if L parallel to M, if L parallel to M, then this angle is equal to, we have to give one, this is angle 1. So angle 1 is equal to 110 degrees, because L parallel to M, 1 is equal to 110 degrees due to vertically opposite angle. If angle 1 is equal to 110 degrees, then we have to find the value of x. So here L parallel to M, angle 1 plus angle X is equal to 180 degrees. If L parallel to M, this is the transversal line, same side of the angle, interior angle, this is called co-interior angle. Co-interior angle. Co-interior angle, some property we have to use it there. This is possible only when L parallel to M, the transversal line. So angle X, here so angle 1 is equal to 110 degrees plus X is equal to 180 degrees. So here angle X is equal to 180 degrees minus 110 degrees. So angle X is equal to 180 minus 110, that is equal to 70 degrees. So this is the X is equal to
question we have taken it the same here. If in the given figure and the arc of the angles, the parallel ABC are 70 degrees.
This is the figure that is given to you, ABC.
ABC is given to them. Find DGC and DEF.
DGC, we have to find DGC and DEF.
And another line is parallel to given to them. The figure two angles are parallel. If ABC is equal to 70 degrees.
If ABC angle ABC is equal to 70 degrees. Two angles are parallel. Parallel means this line are parallel to this line. If this is parallel, then angle ABC that is equal to DGC. Angle ABC equal to angle DGC. Why these are equal? Because two parallel angles are given. This is parallel, angle are parallel, the lines are parallel. So same side of the angle, this is corresponding angle. So DGC is equal to angle DGC equal to 70 degrees. DGC equal to 70, then DEF is also equal to angle DEF. DGC equal to DEF. Why they are equal? Because parallel lines, two angles are parallel, then this is the corresponding angle, this is the corresponding angle, then DEF is also 70 degrees. So both of the angles are 70 degrees. If angles are parallel, then lines are parallel. If the lines are parallel, then angles are parallel and equal. So we have to continue the same. The figure is given to them. The figure is given to them, and we have to find the angle. Thank you.